Thank you very much, Reverend Lane. Yesterday, I gave a sermon on social justice in Lancaster, Pennsylvania, and as I was driving, I was told that there would be a lot of Bible students in the audience. This is for the Friday prayers. And so while driving, what little Googling I could do, I shared the story of the Luke, from the chapter of the Luke on social justice. So thank you very much for sharing that. Our next speaker is Rabbi Krantz, who will be speaking on the Jewish perspective to repair the world. And Rabbi Krantz is also an old partner with the Delaware Council and also a co-founder of J Street. That was the first Jewish organization that I joined and gave money to. Thank you.
It's a pleasure to be here with all of you and a privilege to say a few words. I'm a retired rabbi from Armagh, New York, living now very happily here in Delaware. I want to be clear that rabbis do not participate in programs during the Sabbath, which is, of course, for us today. The Sabbath is only violated to save a human life or when a human life is at stake. I'm here today because I believe that human lives are at stake. Today, we are experiencing an unprecedented assault on various minorities in our country. And that is where social justice must come into call. The Jewish religion is very clear, unambiguous regarding social justice. Tzedek, tzedek, tirdof. Leman techiyeh. Justice, justice you shall pursue so that you shall live. It's not the pursuit of justice. Tirdof means to run, to chase after, to go after justice so that we all will live. And I was thinking about being here today and the events leading up to today, and what came to my mind are words we know from 2,000 years ago, not from our religious tradition, but these words. Civis Romanus sum. I am a Roman citizen. The word citizen, civis in Latin, is the root meaning of vital words not at all unrelated to justice. Vital words in our English language that we know so well. Civic, civil, civilization, city, and of course, citizen. What I have asked myself in recent days and over the years is, what is the meaning of the word civis? What does civil mean? What do citizenship and civilization mean, and what do they have in common? That they trace their origins to the Latin word civis. So I've been thinking about all of us and what these words mean, and I remembered a book I read on civility by the gifted sociologist John Murray Cudahy, in which he explains that every civil right has a hidden proviso, a bourgeois right, he calls it, and that all civil rights are fragile, he would teach us. Cudahy would go on to explain that there is an unarticulated foundational assumption in the Constitution of the United States of America. And that underlying assumption is that you have to be nice. Underlying the entire social and political structure is the reality that we have to be nice. We have to be civil in our actions and in our words. We are now living our lives in a time when ugly voices, mean voices, are magnified beyond reason. There was a terrorist event this week here in the United States. Clearly, that's where all the evidence seems to point. There was another mass shooting in our country. There could be more. There are perhaps links to ISIL. I don't know. and I don't really know how much that matters at all. What I believe matters is the language we use to describe terrorist events in our country. A number of years ago, in a telephone conversation with a friend of mine named Benny Temkin, who was a professor in Israel and a member of the Knesset, the conversation was during the 1990s, and he said to me, "You know, Douglas, words are like bullets." What he meant is that words can be destructive of the very fabric of society the same way in which a bullet is destructive when it races through human flesh. When I hear people talk about radical Islamic terrorism, I hear people granting others a license to kill. When do we talk about radical Jewish terrorism? I don't hear it. When did we hear in our country about radical Christian terrorism when we are reading the history of the Ku Klux Klan in the United States? Or when do we use that in reference to Timothy McVeigh, who was a Christian and committed an act of terror? The expression radical Islamic terrorism represents dangerous words. Make no mistake about it. Those who use expressions like radical Muslim terrorism are not only demagogues like Joe McCarthy, they are dangerous people, and they are giving license to those who wish to hate. So today, I've come here on the Sabbath because I believe we need to stand together, because lives are at stake. And I know that if anyone can figure out a way to go after Muslims or Sikhs or anybody else, someone will figure out a way to come after me. We are citizens of a wonderful country. We are to be referred to not by our religion, but by our citizenships. We affirm by our presence here together that we are Americans. And I thank you for the invitation to be here and to stand with you, especially today.